Hey, everybody, welcome to the show. It's that time of the day. It's that time of the week. Guess what, Timothy?
What, Zachary?
It is Friday. It's a freaky Friday. Friday the 13th, happy hour, a dish.
I really doubt that it's Friday the 13th.
It's got to be coming up.
It's like two a year, right?
Statistically, I think I made that up.
I'm already quoting you on that. Awesome, man.
I mean,
awesome.
I totally didn't make that up.
No, that's scientific fact. Yes. You look at a calendar.
I published it in the Journal of Science.
Journal of Nature.
Yeah. Well, yeah. And it's been replicated many, many times.
Interesting episode, though.
It was. Thank you.
Yeah. I'm not going to say I liked it.
Good point.
Okay. What I mean by that is it was very well done. And I...
Don't flatter me.
Better than I would have done with it. But it's frustrating and it's frightening. And it's like... it's dangerous, you know?
Well, it's one of those theories where it's like, okay, you kind of have to understand what the origins of a couple of different things are and then kind of start lining up the facts in such a way where you say, okay, well, I can see maybe how you believe this. But yes. Yeah, I mean, it yes. touches on, yes. unfortunately, it touches on kind of the dangerous side of the conspiracy theory trend.
Exactly.
Which is not my favorite part.
No, it's so much more fun to talk about aliens and Bigfoot. Exactly. I am on the record as saying we should just do 100% aliens and Bigfoot.
Aliens, yes. Bigfoot, no.
There's so much untapped potential.
I can't edit that, Tim.
I can't edit that out. So much untapped potential with Bigfoot. Seriously, we've barely scratched the surface. But Fort Detrick, Maryland, if you live there in Fredericksburg, yeah. did I
No.
get that?
No. No. and now I got to check. I want to say Frederick, Maryland.
Frederick, Maryland. Yeah. Okay. Well, or if you work there in some bio lab, we'd love to hear from you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Actually, confirm A.
Yes.
What we talk about. B, that all my facts are 100% accurate.
Exactly. So. But no, it was good, man. It was good because it just really helped me understand why that specific conspiracy got going and why people still believe it to this day.
Yeah, it's one of those where it just hasn't gone away. It's mm-hmm. not, I think, obviously quite as big as it was at one point in time, but it's like, okay, people still believe it.
Yep.
A pretty decent subset of the population still believes it. And so I think, you know, to that end, it's like, okay, we got to talk about it.
Yeah, no, absolutely. What would be more fun to talk about is the ABC lineup on Sunday night in the late 80s, huh?
I remember that TV in my parents' kitchen. It actually was the knob.
Oh, sure, sure.
And, yeah. you know...
how many TVs did you have in your house, you fancy kitchen TV watching family?
We had three.
Wow.
Kitchen,
look at you.
I don't want to brag. Kitchen, living room, and basement.
Oh, wow. Yeah, we had one, and then we got a new one. I think we moved one to the basement, but that wasn't until much later.
Well, we didn't get a new fancy TV until, like... late 90s mm-hmm. and it was like the TV that we had my parents bought like in 1980, so it was like,
yeah,
like this giant wooden box that yep. weighed 7 billion pounds.
Yep. And it takes, you know, 5 or 6 seconds to turn on the tubes. Yeah. Got to warm up.
That's exactly right.
It's true.
The actual the TV itself actually sprouted roots and grew into the floorboards of the house.
Right.
It was actually integrated.
Uh-huh. Hey, speaking of TVs, speaking about that sort of thing, I'm trying to figure out how to get football games without buying cable or a dish.
Oh, I wouldn't know anything about that.
And I don't feel like destroying my new TV by watching streamed, Russian pirated football games.
Sure.
But YouTube Live?
That's a real thing. You can, okay, so.
But they still have blacked out games, right?
I'm sure they do.
Wait,
what's your story? Like, who do you want to watch? I mean, probably the Packers.
The Packers. Right? I mean, really, I just want to watch the Packers.
But you can watch it over the air.
I do watch it over the air, except for the times where it's blacked out. When the Vikings and the Packers are both playing at noon on Fox, you know?
I forgot about that.
And it happens inevitably about four times a season. But I don't yes. want to spend, you know, $100 and God knows how many dollars to do that, you know, to get that package to just watch those four games
totally.
I could have gotten otherwise, you know?
Totally, yes.
Because, like, I don't want any other cable channels. I don't want anything other than my Packers. I just want my Packers. Gosh,
you know,
I miss the Packers.
If YouTube TV doesn't have that streaming capability yes. for all teams, like...
I suppose I could VPN it, make it look like I'm in Denmark or something.
It doesn't work. I've tried that. I've gone on vacation.
Yeah.
Right. Airplane mode it.
Sure.
And yeah. then I was, something like DirecTV or whatever I had at the time still made me log into or like turn on my device location.
You had, it's like, oh, your router's in Minnesota. It's like, no.
Exactly. Because, yeah, you know what it does, actually, now that I remember this. Yeah. The VPN, it wasn't looking at the VPN. It was looking at your GPS location.
No way.
Mm-hmm. Which you can't change. That's like just always on.
You can't change.
Yeah, I know. I'm sure somebody out there can. But no, that's a real thing. So like if I could, honestly, if I could just do for what? Five months?
Yeah, that's all I want.
And maybe what? How much would I spend? I'd be willing to spend $40 a month
for
every NFL game on TV.
Oh my God, that'd be amazing.
I don't want anything else.
Nope. I don't need the Home Shopping Network. I don't need Comedy Central. Right. I don't even need ESPN, unless that's where the games are being shown on Monday nights now, I guess. So maybe I do need
and that. And there's always one random one on like the NFL Network.
Yeah.
Which is really weird. Anyways, right. So don't do that. Don't do that.
Right.
But what I would say is like I would spend that money. And there was a hot minute when I had DirecTV. And they gave for free.
Yeah.
NFL Red Zone. I felt so rich. Yeah. I was like, oh, let me go check out, you know, the Bucks v. Atlanta. Like,
yeah, right. Sure. 3:30 on a Sunday.
It was fantastic. There were entire days. And especially because this is back in law school when we went on the weekends.
Uh-huh.
Go to class in the morning, come back, I'm tired. Boom. I'd watch football from noon until basically 10:30 at night.
Well, your brain's fried anyway. It was so it's like, what else are you going to do?
It was awesome. Eat snacks.
Oh my God.
Sit around. It was wonderful.
Oh, that sounds good, man. We should do that. Yeah. NFL Network or just the NFL, Roger Goodall. Listener Roger, hook us up. I mean, you can advertise on this podcast. We'll let you.
Yeah, we're looking for a corporate sponsor.
I think we could convince Warren Buffett to okay the NFL.
Yeah. Get his vote. I'll talk to him.
Yeah, okay.
Shareholder Warren. Uh-huh. Roger Goodell. We're looking for a sponsor, NFL. So I don't see why not.
Uh-huh.
Just do it.
Just do it.
Give us free football.
Yeah, give us free football.
It can't be that hard. It's not like you're going to lose anything.
Right. Oh, man. I just really hope there's a season this year.
Me too. And I hope nobody's watching this specific happy hour.
No, they tuned out like 5 minutes ago. It's all good.
Well, I tell you what, Tim, let's wrap it up here, man. It's getting late. Even though it looks like it's broad daylight outside.
Yeah, no, it's not late. It's actually the early morning sun rising.
That's yeah, we're going to go to bed. All right, folks, have a wonderful weekend. See you bright and early Monday morning, 5 a.m. CST.
We will see you then.
Thank you.